Hey guys, welcome back to Paradise. So if you guys are out there looking for a truck camper, probably one of your biggest questions is going to be, how big of a truck do I need to get with this? Do I need to get a half ton, or do I need to go bigger and get a 3/4 ton or a 1 ton truck? So today I'm just going to chat a little bit about that. There's a lot of myths going around that you can't put a truck camper on a half ton and you should upgrade, and there's obviously a lot of truths out there too about the same thing. So the biggest thing is obviously, what size truck camper are you going to get? How big do you want to go? You can get them from probably about 500 pounds if you want to spend like a lot of money just trying to get a really light one, so you couldn't put it on a smaller truck. Or I've seen some up to about 4,000 pounds that have the slide outs and are about $50,000-$60,000. So that all depends, obviously. If you're going to go bigger, then you've got to get a bigger truck. So there's no way you're going to put it on a half ton. But if you want to go smaller and lighter and like a pop-up, they're usually lighter as well, you should be able to put it on a half ton. But it all depends on how much stuff you're bringing with and just the dry weight and everything like that. So like our camper here, we have the pop-up Shadow Cruiser. It's a 1995. And dry weight is actually like 1,000 pounds. Or wet weight is actually 1,000 pounds. So we actually took a lot of the stuff out anyways. So with all of our stuff in it, we're probably about 1,000 pounds. It's not too bad. And then with us in it as well. There's a fly. Hold on. It's actually a pretty light camper, considering it actually does hang over the back and stuff. It's not too bad. But this is just a Chevy 1500, and it holds it well. The payload on this truck is 1762, I believe, something around there, 17 something. But it's been holding it well. But we don't bring a lot of stuff with us. Like I said, we ripped a lot of the stuff out as well. So it depends on, obviously, your camper that you're getting. I've seen a lot of them by like the four-wheel campers or whatever. They're like pretty much 20,000 just for just the base model. So if you want to spend a ton of money and get a really light one, or you could spend more money and get a beefed up truck. So it depends on kind of what you're using it for. If you're going to go off-roading and stuff, then you probably need a lighter camper so you can get off-road and have a smaller truck. Or if you're just going to go to campgrounds, then the bigger one's probably fine. But based on payload, with your half tons, there's a lot of different configurations you can get. So to get the most payload out of your truck, you pretty much want to go with two-wheel drive and just the regular cab. That's going to get you the most payload of any truck out there for a 1500, because they're usually over 2,000 pounds payload, so that's usually pretty good. And the new Ford F-150s are like 3,000 pounds with that. So, and then obviously if you add four-wheel drive, that lowers the payload, and if you add the back door, that lowers the payload, and pretty much anything that adds weight to the vehicle will lower the payload. So if you want the big back door, we just have the extended cab, but if you want the bigger back door, that'll lower it. If you get the shorter bed, that'll lower it. So with that being said, there's lots of truck campers out there that you can get that would fit onto a half ton. You just might have to do some research, and depending again on what you are needing it for. Like these older ones, they're usually actually pretty light and they're pretty cheap, but a lot of them obviously don't function as well as they're supposed to, like with the water and the gas and all that stuff. It's kind of older, so it might be a little deteriorated, which we didn't really need it, so that worked out well for us. But if you want all the whatever luxuries, then you're going to pay a little more, and then it might be lighter, but you're kind of paying for the lightweight aluminum and all that stuff with it. So it just depends. Obviously, if you want more of the luxuries, then it's probably worth it to go up, because it's not worth being over payload if you're going to be full timing it and leaving it on the truck all the time, because that's going to just tear your truck apart, and then end up you're going to have to pay more in the long run. You could just upgrade to a 250 or 350 right away. So I hope you guys found this handy. If you have any more questions about payload or trucks or truck campers, just leave them in the description below, and we'll talk to you guys next time. Bye.